Buddy, welcome to 259 Cedar Hill at the IPG factory for the materials processing systems and where we build the LaserCube product. Today we've got something challenging. We've got a pre-punched sheet of parts. This thing's gone through a punch press. It's all deformed. We're going to use vision capabilities on the machine to precision align to each one of these parts prior to processing. At the end of the day, this little bad boy is going to be a perfect fit with perfect repeatability across the board. Vision is going to get us there. With me today is Sean Dennigan. He's one of the experts on the LaserCube, and will be giving us a little explanation of how the vision alignment capabilities can solve some production problems. In the case here, we've got a pre-punched sheet of, I guess this is stainless?
This is aluminum.
Okay, we got aluminum. And during the punching process, I think there's been some deformation of the part and so forth. And we want to make sure the part that we yield from here has very tight alignment to these clearance holes that we're going to use to bolt this into our assembly. So, Sean, what are some of the problems you see with parts like this when your customers come to you and say, hey, we want to get 100% yield out of this part?
Well, typically on any punched product, the forming process will move the material around. I mean, that's what it's designed to do, after all. But even if I had a CAD model showing where those features are supposed to be, it probably moved a little bit during the process. So we have several different alignment options in our software to compensate for that, so that from one part to another, you get a consistent product. What I'll be demonstrating today is what we call our one-point alignment. It's a little bit of a misnomer because I still am going to take 2 points to get the entire sheet running straight, but for each individual part that I ask it to make, I'll be taking one additional vision point, so that's why we call it 1 point. And that will give it its own individual start point. And that way, from one part to the other, I get a pretty consistent result. But if you inspect your parts after that's all done, and you find it's still not consistent, we have what we call a three-point alignment. Once again, we're still going to do the 2 points to get everything running straight, but in each individual part, I'll be taking 3 points. 2 points to get the part itself running straight, and then one additional point to recenter it. So it'll have its own skew and its own start position.
Well, it's kind of like unique coordinate system offsets for each one of these. First at the panel level, and then at the individual part level.
Exactly.
Well, that's pretty sophisticated. And we've got some hardware on the machine that does this, a camera system?
Well, the camera system's on the machine, yes, but it's all our software that does the heavy lifting, does the math.
Why don't we take a look at the software? Because it sounds like there's a lot of capability there. So, Sean, we've got up here, this, I guess, is our LaserCube, software interface, and you've got the camera set up here. I can see my crosshairs. Why don't you give us a little explanation of what the different software functionalities you have here?
Well, first we're going to actually go to the settings page. We set up the job, the program, and the tech data. The tech data is basically the parameters used for cutting. And then on your panel layout page, what we have is set up for a printed array layout. In the case of our punched products, since we already have features that we're going to use for alignment, the printed array is the appropriate layout. On this side, we have the 2 points that we're going to use to get the entire sheet running straight. And over here, we have our different alignment levels. So you can see I have it set to 1 point, as we discussed previously. And that way, for each individual part that I ask it to run, it'll run one additional vision alignment to recenter. We tell it the number of rows and columns, and then we actually teach it these three important points highlighted in blue, and then the software does the math to figure out the step and repeat. So once again, if your product is moved, this does compensate for that.
So talk us a little bit about the two-point alignment that you're going to use for the initial thing. How's that set up?
So I picked two parts on the sheet that I know are in the same axis. In this case, I'm going to choose the lower left and the lower right hand.
That would be this one and this one?
Yes. But inside the part itself, so each one of these squares represents one of these parts.
Mm-hmm.
In order to get the maximum accuracy for overall sheet alignment, I'm going to choose the lower left-hand hole in this part and the lower right-hand hole in that part.
Okay.
The greater the distance, the greater your accuracy.
Longer baseline for your measurement. Excellent.
So I would move to that position. Verify that I'm in the right position.
Yeah.
And all I have to do is hit the teach button to teach that location.
So you just taught the nominal location for the first point. Okay.
Correct. If you're going to be using the... You can do this all manually, but if you want to use the camera, then I teach what it's going to look for. So you have two rectangles. You have this blue rectangle that it's hard to see because it takes up the whole screen, giving you the best chance of finding what your part is. And the red rectangle, which is your region of interest, and that's what you're looking for. So within the blue rectangle, you're searching for what's in the red rectangle. When I'm happy with that, I take a snapshot of it. So it takes this image, blows it up here, and that way I can fine-tune. You can see I'm not perfectly centered there, so I just fine-tune, take the picture again, and now I'm perfectly in the center. And once I'm happy with that, I'll lock it in.
All right, so by teaching that region of interest, you're able to define what that feature should look like. So if a part were to get onto the machine that didn't have that feature, if it was mispunched, you've got some level of control to say, hey, there's something wrong with the part.
Exactly. And you can test it by just moving to an area somewhat away from that and hitting the search button, and you'll see it finds and centers. So just move around a couple times.
Okay, so what it's doing there, if I'm not mistaken, it's searching within the blue box that you've defined, a fairly large area.
Yep.
It's identifying this feature and saying, that's my feature of interest, and then it's translating it into the center of the crosshairs.
And that's how it establishes...
And then it's capturing that XY machine coordinate.
Exactly.
Okay.
That's target one. For target two, I would just do the exact same thing. I'd move to the other side, as I discussed before. Go off the sheet, so I know it's the far right.
Mm-hmm.
Move to the center of this feature. Teach target two. And that way, those two points will define straight for the sheet itself.
So I noticed you taught two different targets. So this could be a different feature shape.
It could be absolutely anything you can see on this screen.
So you don't have to have the same features for each of the alignments. That's pretty interesting.
You don't even have to have what's typically considered features. If you had text there, you could use the letter R at the end of...
Interesting. Oh, so that would be great for nameplates.
Exactly.
Right? You want to get Roger's name centered squarely in his nameplate for his...
So you use the capital R on this part, and the lowercase r for the last part of Roger on that part.
Okay, and this is all set up. Once you're set up, you're just going to be running that whole stack of sheets. And I think I saw 30 or 40 in the back that you're going to be processing. So you can walk away and let the operator just, load and run this machine day after day. And everything's saved to get a repeat order in a couple of weeks. You don't have to reprogram anything.
Once it's saved, it's there forever.
All right. So what else do we want to see on this screen?
So in order for the printed array to work, I have to teach these three locations so that it can accurately calculate the step and repeat. So I'm going to go move back to target one over here.
Okay.
And grab this start position. So I'm going to look at the program. Let's see where this crosshair is where the program is set to start. So I know it's that lower left hole in this part.
Okay.
So that's the hole that I was using for my target one position, so I know I'm there. So I will select this and say it's the start position for this feature. Then I'll move over to the far right feature. So once again, I'm going to go off the sheet so I know I'm on the right feature. That would be the lower left hole that we used for our target two, but we want the start position, and the start position is this lower right hole, so we're going to continue over.
That's because you used a longer baseline, but now you're programming the origin, if you will, of the unique punched features. So
and the origin of each one of these is going to be the same.
It's always going to be the same up at this location.
Correct.
All right.
So I'll move to that position, select this part, so you can see the highlighted box,
yep,
and teach that position. Now that those positions are taught in the X-axis, I can use it to move back to this location.
And I'll move. You're back here, now you're going up there.
And once again, I'll go off the part so I know that I'm at the right, the topmost part. This would be the top hole, and I will just continue on to the next hole. Search for it, select, and teach that. And now that those three features are taught, it's all the ones you need to teach, now I should be able to go to any part on here and say move to, and I'll move to the upper right.
So you went to this one, and it's found its piece. Now you've moved over.
Move to the next one down. Next one down. Next one down. And you can see they all go to approximately the right spot. Not important that they go to the exact right spot, because once again, every time I cut a part, it will take another vision alignment and recenter. So even if I don't go to the exact perfect spot, it will get there.
These are pretty close, the ones that you've just showed us. But as long as it's falling within this larger box, if there's a lot of deformation, then we'd still be able to find it.
That's exactly the case.
Cool. That's pretty nifty. I'm pretty impressed.
That's all there is to it. Now the part's ready to run.
Well, let's go ahead and see what it does. Once, this is aluminum, right? So we're going to use your tech tables to program the materials?
Yep. As I said before, when you start the job, we loaded the part program, which teaches it how to move, and we loaded the tech table, which teaches it how to fire the laser, what parameters to use firing the laser. So that's already been loaded. Now we loaded the vision system. Now that that's complete, we're ready to run.
Let's see it run, man. I want to see it go. Well, Sean, that was pretty nifty. Let's take a look at the results. So you got that sheet, you cut all 24. Obviously for the camera angles, we paused it intermittently, but that's cool. Let's just see how it take this reference part, my golden standard, and let's just overlay it. And man, that thing's spot on. Let's just check a couple of them. And that one's spot on as well. I think the customer's gonna be happy with these results. And now I'm popping this part out of your panel because you made it easy to separate. But there we go. Excellent results, Sean. Thank you.
Thanks.
All right, everybody. Thank you again for joining us here at Cedar Hill in Marlborough, Massachusetts for a quick introduction to the vision systems on the LaserCube product. For more information, follow the link below.